once upon a time in my past, I was what you would consider a very obedient person. Now, that's not a bad thing if you, you know, obey the laws and the rules without questioning. You're certainly free to do that, and I certainly exercised that right that I too had when I was a very obedient person. I obeyed the ground rules in schools and at the church and in my parents' apartment, you know, what they said went. And I didn't stray from that, or I didn't bring it home, right? I didn't specifically disobey them by doing something in their home that they would not like us to do. I obeyed, you know, I never obeyed the crosswalk thing, because growing up in New York and New Jersey, you cross in the middle of the street and that's normal. Now that I've been going across the country, I'm seeing that people actually follow, you know, the crosswalk signals of the, you know, walking sign or the stop sign. And I got to tell you, I had a little hard time not adjusting to it. You know, when it was there and it was, I was able to do it, I did it. I didn't do it to be obedient. I just did it as a courtesy to others. But, you know, I worked in New York City. I would run right across the street, you know, doing the Frogger. So, sorry, but that's just the way it was. And I still honor myself for that. Because, you know, I'm an adult. I can think for myself. But anyway, what is this video about? It's about blindly obeying and being obedient versus critical thinking. And what is the difference from my vantage point? So, stay tuned. Welcome to A Few Minutes with Marvin. I inspire those who aspire to make positive changes in their world. And as you know by now, this video is about just obeying blindly versus having critical thoughts. It's not for or against obedience, but it is skewed towards critical thought. I'll be upfront and honest about that. So if you have an issue with that, then you may want to turn away from this video. But I do it with love and light. It's not about, you know, espousing, you know, my platform and what I believe and what you should believe. You believe what you believe. But as I say in all of my videos, make sure that it is actually what you believe and not what you were told to believe by others, right? And, you know, they're not, if they are telling you what to do, it may not be out of malice, but in some situations it is. I just want to inform you that there is a difference, and you may want to really critically think before you just do what you're told. And I know we've been told differently by our parents growing up as children. You have to obey the law. You have to obey the rules. You have to do what you're told. You have to sit down and listen to the sermon quietly, whether you want to or not. And again, I'm going to say this. This is not against religion. It's not against politics. It's not against anything, right? And why does it have to be against anything, right? Why do I have to preface it by saying that? I shouldn't have to. I have my rights of free speech. And you have a right to listen or not to listen. And it's all good. It's all good. So, let's get into this, shall we? So throughout this video, I'm going to put up certain clips, and they're clips from, you know, movies, stills, and books, and, you know, powerful quotes from people that we revere and that we looked up to. But they're going to challenge the way that you think, you know, and that's critical thought, right? You don't have to listen to them. You don't have to listen to anybody, you know. Is the point of this video. You have to believe you, and you have to believe what you believe. we have been conditioned to just go with the flow and follow everybody else. So there's no fault here, there's no blame here, it just is. It's been all our lives, all of our parents' lives, all of their parents' lives. Why, you might ask? There's lots of reasons. There really are. And if you're really interested, I really, you know, suggest that you do some research. Look into books like 1984 by George Orwell and see what the message is and the underlying message. Watch the movie They Live by John Carpenter featuring Roddy Piper. If you don't know the premise of that movie, is this construction guy finds these pair of glasses, and every time he puts them on, he looks at a billboard. It's not showing him the Coca-Cola sign. The word obey is back there, or control. You know, any just subliminal messages. I have a few videos on, you know, the frequency and the underlying tones, but there's also things hidden in billboards and messages. And I'm not looking to be labeled. Again, I'll say it again. This isn't about conspiracies. This is about hidden in plain sight truth. Now, a lot has gone on since 2020, and if you're not aware of it, we've been asked to obey a lot over the last 2 or 3 years. Blindly, in fact, because now some of the things that are coming out about the pandemic were not supported in science. But back then, we were told that these things were scientifically proven and based in fact. There was no fact. We were just being asked to obey, right? For the good of other human beings, for the good of our cities and our country and the world, right? But what they were telling us to obey had no fact behind it. Critical thinking would have stopped all this if people had just stopped and thought first, wait a minute, we've had pandemics before, or actually we have had pandemics before. Go back and look at what the process was and what the premise was and how long these lasted and how many people passed and what was the percentages, right? If you look back, Spanish flu, there's lots of the swine flu, all of those, you know, viruses. If you go deeper into them, you'll find out that even some of those weren't what we were told they were, but we were told to obey them. You know, especially, you know, I'll mention it again, when the AIDS epidemic hit, it was fear. It was in the 70s, I was a child, and we were scared to death about being around gay people. And I had gay relatives at the time, you know. But, you know, and then the jokes came about it and the judgment, right? That was a narrative. But we were told to obey what we were being told by the CDC or whoever was in charge back then and the government, you know. Critical thought would have encouraged you to go deeper and to look deeper into it. You can look into lots of places on YouTube and all over the internet for differences of opinions about the AIDS pandemic, this past COVID pandemic, lots of things. Now, they're being labeled as conspiracy theories only because there's a certain faction that wants you to obey blindly. And lots of people are obeying blindly. And again, if you truly feel that you were not being lied to, that you're not being manipulated, and you wanted to do what was best for your friends, your family, your neighbors, the country, I honor you. I truly honor you. That being said, did you think about it first? Or did you say, I don't want to lose my job. If I don't get this needle in my arm, I'll lose my job and my life will be over. So I have to obey this. If during this whole thing you said, I have to do it because I'm told to do it, you weren't critically thinking, you were blindly obeying without considering that there may have been a possibility that this wasn't what we were being told. In fact, the numbers coming, you know, that have been around forever now, it was 99%, you know, survival rate for people that were healthy. Now, if you had a compromised immune systems and elderly and things of that nature, yes, there were lots of people who suffered from it. And I send them so much love and blessings and sympathy to the families. This isn't about, you know, saying it was a hoax. Not at all. Don't take it that way. I'm not putting it out there that way. I'm putting this out there with unconditional love. But it's our most recent thing. So it's relevant right now. Did you just follow blindly? And if you did, was it your choice? Everything comes down to the choice, right or wrong. It's not right or wrong. It's just a choice. Now, once you make a choice, then you have to face the consequences of that choice. Now, if you choose to just go, you know, with the herd and follow what everybody else is doing because they told you it has to be done, there's a consequence to that. And once you make that decision to do it, to obey, to follow, then later down the road, when something comes up and is going to lead to some consequences for those actions and that choice, you can't say, well, I was just doing what I was told, because you're going to be found complicit in that. You know, just because you were ignorant about it and decided not to do some research or critically think about it, doesn't mean that you're not accountable to that decision. You're accountable for all your decisions, but to yourself, right? This isn't a video telling you that not to obey the laws or the rules. This is a video asking you to critically think before you take action and say, is this thing for the highest good of myself? I understand that there are other people involved, and yes, I do have to take those into consideration too, but first I have to think about myself and my family first and what is best for me and for us. And if it goes against the narrative, then so be it. That's critical thinking. But you make that clear choice. And if following and obeying, turn, you know, in your heart of hearts, in your soul, is the best thing for you and your family, fantastic. Go for it. Do it. It's the right choice for you. Our souls chose to come here and reincarnate. If you don't know if you believe in reincarnation or not, but for me, it's a real thing. And we're here to experience things. But we also have free will. If we're able to change our own destinies, right, by saying, oh, you know, I'm going to do this regardless, right, and do it. Now you've made a free will choice. Even if your soul's telling you otherwise and saying, don't do that, you go, nope, you know, I'm a free being, I'm going to do that. You're certainly entitled to that. And I honor you for that. Right? But again, just know that carries, your choice carries a response, right? It's another, you know, you're shifting a timeline, as it were. You know, the Avenger movies are great examples of, you know, how we can shift our own timelines. Again, that's my opinion, and a lot of people share that opinion about the different timelines and multi-dimensions are real for me. So when you make a choice, you're shifting a timeline, right? Or you're staying on a timeline, and other people know how to manipulate those timelines. So if they want you to follow a narrative so that you stay in the timeline that they want to play out, that's gonna bring the results that they want, then they're gonna bombard you with guilt and judgment and the frequencies, right, to keep you in low vibrations so that you stay obedient, so that you don't critically think, that you don't question. To be obedient for me is not to question anything. That's, in my opinion, that's not a good thing. And I've done it. I've followed, right? You know, I was the best at what I did because I followed the rules sometimes. A lot of times. But in following those rules, I also threw some people under the bus. So for me to obey, I have to go against somebody else's free will and say that's not okay. No, I did it, and many people do it, but it's not okay. We're free beings. We have our own free will. I can't force you to do anything that you don't want to do. I can't force you to believe anything you don't want to believe. And you can't force me. But we're in this world now where that's what's happening. People are going against other people because they believe differently than you. What makes you right? What makes anybody that's pushing other people to do something against their free will right? They're not wrong to themselves. They can certainly put it out there, and just like I'm putting this video out, if it resonates with you, fantastic. You know, you're gonna learn a lot. But if it doesn't, then you have the right to turn away from it, right? Just like, you know, the politicians and the lawyers and, you know, institutions and teachers, they can put all this information out there and say, okay, you know, whoever's meant to learn from it is going to learn from it. But they should say, whoever doesn't, it's okay. That's not what the world we're living in now. It's not okay now to go against somebody else's thoughts, somebody else's agendas. That's obedience. That's not critical thought. And that's not what we free beings were put on this planet for. I choose not to just obey. There are laws, of course. And those people who disobey those laws know the consequences of disobeying those laws. Do they get away with it? Of course. Politicians get away with it. You know, teachers get away with it. You know, everybody, you know, they're you know, normal people get away with it. It's not about the getting away with it. It's those, you chose that experience, right? And there's still a consequence, whether it comes now or comes later, doesn't matter. But you chose it willingly. So to disobey someone is not a bad thing. And it's not a good thing. It just is. It was just a choice that you made in that moment. So if you chose to get the vaccinations, you've made a choice. It's not a good thing or it's not a bad thing. You know, I certainly don't judge you for it, and I wouldn't, and I expect not to be judged for my decision. And if somebody does judge me, you know, that's fine. You know, I send them away with love. Hey, that's your opinion. You're certainly entitled to it. But I'm doing me. And if you see that as disobedience, I don't see it as disobedience. And you're right, and I'm right. You're right to you, and I'm right to me. And that's all that really matters. And you may say, well, if people go, you know, around disrespecting or disobeying each other or going against each other, then this world will never, you know, get to a good place. Well, it's gotten to the place it is now because people have blindly followed, in my opinion. If people had thought more and stood up more for what they believe in, there'd be a lot more harmony and unity right now. There wouldn't be all this division and all this stuff that's going on, you know? And now we're being asked to obey and obey, obey, obey more, more, more. That's somebody putting a foot on your neck and keeping you oppressed. In my opinion, that's not for me. If it's for you, all right, cool. You got it. But make sure it's what you want. And look into the possibilities of the consequences. If you follow blindly and this doesn't turn out to be the truth, what did that just cost you? What did it cost your family? Right? How far back did that set you? What are you going to do now? Critical thinking will allow you to plan, right? So, for example, with the news that's on now, all the news, I don't watch TV, but there's a lot going on. How do you choose what to believe and not to believe? Or do you just say, that news outlet said it, so it's the truth. It was on the internet, so it's the truth. Is it? The only way you're going to know is if you go beyond those typical places and just look at other opinions, right? And then feel it in your soul. And you know, if you meditate on it and say, hey, I'm a little confused about this. My guides, my higher self, the Supreme Being, give me a little bit of help here. I need some clarity. And it'll come. But if you just say, oh, they said I got to do it, so I got to do it. Well, other things are going to come too. And sending you love and light. This isn't with a negative or a positive thing that I'm discussing. It's just to open your minds so that you can, start to think critically instead of just being obedient for the sake of being obedient because it was ingrained in our head that you obeyed your parents, you obeyed your teachers, you obeyed the ministers and pastors, and you obeyed the police officers and the government officials. They're not wrong, right? And when they were saying that, right? Because again, it was all passed on. Our parents did the same thing. You had to obey, obey, obey. But at some point, you got to say, I can't obey something that I don't agree with. And I'm choosing not to. And I choose to experience whatever comes with that. But I know that nothing bad will happen to me because I'm standing in my truth. And I believe what I believe, regardless of what the others believe. And it's my opinion. And you have your own. And if it differs from mine, awesome. That's a good thing. It's a really good thing. So, this video has gone a little longer than I expected it to, but it really is up to you. Make your own decisions. Obey or don't obey. It's not disobey or don't obey. So you don't have to obey. You don't have to. You can choose to. You can also choose to critically think and to do some research and make an informed decision. And if it leads you to obey, fantastic. And if it leads you not to obey, fantastic. Like I said earlier, it's all good. And yes, it can be all good. Because in the real world, there is no right or wrong. There is good and evil. There's still duality, right? But there are different frequencies and different vibrations. right? There's a higher vibration and there's a lower vibration or frequency. You can choose either one. Which one are you going to choose? There's a clear choice to be made. There's always choices to be made. You can sit in obedience, and that's the choice you made, and whatever consequences come with it, the choices that you chose to experience are things that you choose to experience. Same with the other way. You know, if you choose to disobey, then there's consequences and experiences coming to you based on that choice. So, choose. Obedience or disobedience. If you choose to follow blindly, that's your choice. If you choose to stop and look at it and do your own research, that's your choice as well. It's not a good or bad choice. It's your choice. Your choice to make. So, obedience versus critical thought. I choose critical thought. You can too. But if you choose obedience, I honor you and send you many blessings. Because that's a choice. And I just honor the choice. It's not right or wrong. So, if you're struggling with, you know, doing things because you're told versus what you actually feel, and you do things more because you're told rather than how you feel, but you want to change that, and you're afraid to be judged about it, or looked down on, or lose friends or family over it, and you're losing sleep over it, check out my website. I am a spiritual transformation coach. And I can help you, guide you, right? It's not about me doing the work. It's guiding you to do your work to get you some clarity and to step into your power and your truth and know that you can make your own choices regardless of what everybody else thinks or says, right? It's time. It's time for everyone to start making their own choices based on what's best for them and not following blindly or doing it out of guilt or judgment or just because somebody else said they should. That's all. Very simple. If you like the contents of this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it on your social media platforms, leave me a comment. I'd love to know, you know, not that it's good or bad, but, you know, are you critically thinking or are you, you know, do you choose to follow and obey? And there's nothing wrong with that. You know, it's a healthy thing to debate. And to give your own opinion, as I am doing here. And I appreciate those who stayed to the end. I'm grateful for you. Thank you so much. Thank you for spending a few minutes with me. I'm beyond grateful. And if you chose to subscribe, thank you for joining the A Few Minutes with Marvin family. I'm grateful for that as well. So, wishing you all the best. Make the choice. Obey blindly or obey through critical thought or not. Pretty simple choices, but just make sure that you are cognizant, aware, and making them of your own free will. And have an amazing day.